Hey guys, welcome back! We've got some things to cover, but first of all, drum roll please! We've reached 100 subs! And it's not even the end of 2021, hell yeah! Time is a very precious thing nowadays, and the fact that you spend it on my videos is such an honor. I want you to know that I'm thankful for the continuous support every new subscriber puts a smile on my face. Although I know you're not here for my sentimentalism, so let's get to the topic that made you click on this video. It seems that we now have a pattern, meaning the next step to revisit was the hero selection screen. Let's see how the previous versions looked like. In my older ASCII game there were 3 classes and that's it. Then I wanted to let the players create their own heroes, I defined 6 races, 4 classes and 2 genders. We could switch between these settings and see the stats changing with them below. It was fine at first, but then I realized it would be like some kind of MMORPG. Okay, but I wanted to create all the art for every possible outcome. Character sheets, equipment, everything. That would be like 200 items, bruh. Since I make all the coding and art, this would have been impossible to create within a reasonable time. Then I started thinking on the story and I came to the conclusion that we need predefined heroes in the game for better immersion. So that's why you never seen more hero designs in the game. Yet. Now let's see what changed. Since this was the second screen I've made after the start, the code should be a bit messy, right? I mean, I've seen some bad code.
Oh my god, what's this?
Ladies and gents, I came to the conclusion that I haven't used cycles.
Bruh.
There's not much salvageable stuff here, it's better to start over with a clear head and clear code. All this stuff went to the trash bin. I had a cool new design in my head. Since the game will have a story, I thought it would be great if some parts of it would be in a book. The hero selection screen would look like if there's a campsite at the left page, with the heroes casually having some rest, you know, one sleeping, one cooking, etc. While on the right page, we could see all necessary information about them. To this, of course, I had to draw some templates. I wasn't in the mood to create the finished art right at the moment, so I just created some placeholder sprites, just to provide the graphical functionality to the screen. After some tweaking and a lot of crappy code fixing, it looked really good. There was only one thing left to make them kinda playable, except the different equipment and skills. Well, that's another story. They all needed different sprite sheets just to be sure that they work properly. Again, I wasn't in the mood to already create the final versions, more like because the animations will be more complex. The current one has like 6 frames. If you've seen my Septembit submissions, you know that all the heroes there have like 50 frames. So I want to make better animations for my game as well. Again, just some quick sketches, nothing fancy here. And voila, they work. And that's how I recreated my character choice screen. I hope you like it. It was quite fun and don't worry, it will look much better once I make the proper art soon. And to show my appreciation for that sweet 100 subs, I'll make a short Ork Slayer roadmap / what's next video for you. But be sure to help me fight the YouTube algorithm with your likes and subs and feel free to leave any feedback in the comments. Thanks a lot, my friends. See you soon. Stay safe and take care.